There's a big debate in China now because it is, of course, crazy for a developing country that needs to buy capital goods to hold large amounts of dollars, paper dollars in the form of these treasury bonds. The Chinese leadership, they show they're really not as clever as they thought they were. They seem to believe in money in terms of paper money, dollars. Well, these are just green pieces of paper. If you get some dollars, what you damn well better do with them is go and buy some capital goods, go and buy steel mills, go and buy locomotives.
Well, they're starting to do that, though. China's moving into copper, gold.
They're starting to do it. And that was the moment, the gales of laughter for Tiny Tim Geithner, the tax cheat, the turbo tax man, when he went to Beijing University and they basically guffawed him into non-existence, when he said, I want you to know in the worst way that your investments in U.S. Treasury bonds are safe and sound. And they just all started laughing. And I think that's a turning point of world history because it's just untenable.
Because they know a slime bag corporate thief that's destroyed America, a little spider is in there, and it's all just a big joke to them. They're trying to prop up their biggest market. But, I mean, I think the decision has been made globally that it's the end. And I guess we'll just be ruled by a bunch of Geithners and Summers and Rubin running around with military. In the time we've got, Webster, then how do you see this unraveling? And now have you seen the TV ads that are running nationally with people in black and red uniforms marching and they're openly announcing that they're going to be on the streets and are on the streets? I mean, it's actually happening, Webster. It's one thing to say we think it's coming, but I mean, we are descending into hell here.
Yeah, it's obviously a bad scene, and there are these quasi-fascist or fascist militias coming out. But I urge people, don't take yourself out of the equation. This whole regime is extremely vulnerable right now.
I agree.
The big problem is, if you go forward and say, we don't like Obama, but we want the free market, that's a loser. It's not going anywhere.
Yeah, they're going to have us argue between left and right when this has nothing to do with it, and a phony right-wing thing versus a left-wing thing. And then meanwhile, it just goes off the edge of a cliff.
But if you get out there and say, seize General Motors and reconvert it to produce tractors, nuclear reactors, maglev rail, modern capital goods that can be sold in the third world, right? The people in
But the globalists don't want to build up the third world. They want to neutralize them from industry so that they can be controlled.
Absolutely. So you've got to counter that. So you counter them in every way, counter them nationally and internationally. So I think it's time to organize. In other words, I think the Obama deception, your work, and other things have come together now, especially the betrayals of this regime. We have this guy called Ted Rall. He's an interesting guy. I don't know if you saw this, right? The Illinois State Journal Register in Springfield, Illinois. And he comes out with an article saying, it's time for Obama to resign. This is somebody who supported Obama. He says, Obama is a monster. He has betrayed us on everything. He has betrayed us more than any other elected official.
I didn't see it. Who was this?
Ted Rall, R-A-L-L, the Illinois State Journal Register. He's actually an interesting person, a maverick. He was one of the first people to call for the impeachment of Bush.
Stay there. Stay there, Webster. Final segment. I was going to take calls. We took a lot earlier, but I just am out of time. Julio and Chris and Matthew and David and Rick. Call back tomorrow. You'll be there first. We're going to come back in the final segment. Because I want to talk about what they're saying the solution is. Okay, Webster, look, here's the deal. You've got your solutions. I agree with a lot of it. We're not in control of things. The people don't want what the bankers are doing. They want what you're saying. Common sense, it's not happening. Bloomberg's saying, how dare the American people not love that, what's happening with GM. As if, we don't care. As if we haven't been raped enough. That's being used as a distraction of the tens of trillions that have, been sucked out right to the bankers. But they're having a fake solution that is carbon taxes, shutting down most of the industry, as Pelosi said in China, categorizing and registering everything we do, carbon credit, ration cards. I don't think the public realizes that not only are they going to bankrupt things, their new economy is this debt economy by design to bring in neo-feudalism and serfdom that you cover in the Obama deception so eloquently that I hope folks will get at InfoWars.com and show to people quickly. So in closing, how do we have to not just have solutions, we have to discredit their power grab of the whole economy that's left. I mean, there's no way to say this wasn't designed. Everything they're doing is designed to criminally consolidate.
Well, we're all looking forward to the next product coming out of your shop there, if it's July 4th or thereabouts. And there may be possibly ways to regroup further. I mean, we might want to think about some form of conferences, maybe in the late summer, early autumn, bring together various kinds of forces that are in resistance. I know Phil Berg.
Yeah, I wonder if C-SPAN would put us back on. Sorry, go ahead.
It's possible. Phil Berg is continuing to with his lawsuits to expose Obama. He thought he had oral arguments in the Third Circuit in Philadelphia, but they've pushed him now into the autumn. But at a certain point, I think that the climate of opinion begins to change. In other words, I think Obama is now past his peak, and I think people should therefore take heart and redouble their efforts and keep fighting the good fight, because Obama is now more vulnerable. In other words, the idea that these left liberals at their Campaign for America's Future conference are so uncomfortable about the fact that the guy is such an obvious Wall Street puppet, so subservient to Summers and all of these zombie bankers, I think that's beginning to crack this edifice.
Well, I think what began to crack it was him saying no rights for detainees and the torture is going to continue and
right,
we're going to open new camps. I mean, this is ridiculous.
Right, but therefore the big question is economic program. Do you have one? In other words, can you criticize Obama in a way that makes it clear that you're not talking about having the Depression work its full fury on the population, but you're actually proposing solutions that would work? And again, reconverting General Motors to make maglev trains, that's the idea that will, I think, take off and lead us into the future.
Well, certainly that's better than just giving $14.8 trillion to a bunch of criminal bankers.
Clawback. Operation Clawback on the bankers.
Well, we need to audit the Fed. That's going to expose other criminals. We need to get more state sovereignty to expose the central government. Webster Tarpley, great talking to you. Let me say bye to you as the show ends here in just a moment. Retransmission with all the big guests starts now on the web at InfoWars.com. Great job of the crew. We'll be back in 1 minute. Stay with us.